There are many mechanisms which cause the transformation of the yeast form of Candida into its fungal form. One of the ones that we see on a daily basis, and the one which I think is the main cause of the transformation of the yeast to the fungal form of Candida, is the use of antibiotics. Antibiotics, whether directly taken into the body or indirectly through foods, will assist in the development of fungal pathogenic Candida in the body. That happens through several different mechanisms. Since the introduction of antibiotics in the late 1940s, research showed that there were certain antibiotics that possibly directly stimulated this conversion of the yeast to fungal form. Through research since the late 1940s and early 50s and 60s, we know that this happens through a variety of different mechanisms. When you take an antibiotic in the body, what we know is that antibiotics means antibiotic is against life. It destroys life. Life in the form of bacteria, antibiotics are specifically designed to destroy bacteria as opposed to fungus and yeast and parasites and viruses within the tissues. So as you destroy the bacteria in the digestive system, you will destroy basically what we call good and bad bacteria. The reality is they may all be good in terms that they coexist in a way that's beneficial to human health, but there are certain strains which we consider to be problematic, pathogenic, and other strains which we think are more benign and therefore beneficial simply because of their presence in the digestive tract. The reality is that they're all beneficial because they've evolved to coexist in such a way that we can, these bacteria, viruses, mold, parasite, yeast, fungi, derive the nutrients from the foods we eat, and then we're able to absorb those nutrients into the body. So when you take an antibiotic, you destroy bacteria, good, bad, however you want to look at it. The destruction of that bacteria creates more of an open terrain for the yeast to grow into, and it does so in its fungal form more rapidly than it does its yeast form. There are several mechanisms by which the antibiotics will further conversion of the yeast to fungal form of Candida. One of these mechanisms is by destroying the bacteria, it creates space for the fungus to grow into, meaning there's less competition from the bacteria which was previously there. So it's creating an open field space for the Candida to grow. Another way that this happens is that the bacteria that's in there produces lactic acid, or these acids which help to maintain the pH of the intestinal tract at an acidic level. At an acidic level, Candida exists within its yeast form. When it starts to rise to a more alkaline pH, around the pH of 6.5, that induces transformation of the cell wall membrane of the yeast into its fungal form. So we have creating space by eliminating the bacteria. We have a change of pH by eliminating the bacteria which causes acids to maintain an acidic pH. We also have transformation of the yeast cell wall membrane into its fungal form by the effect of when we destroy these bacteria, they release components from their cell wall membranes and from the inside of them, which will also directly stimulate the cell wall membrane of the yeast to convert to its fungal form. So there are a number of these which we know directly stimulate the conversion of the yeast to fungus in Candida. In addition to the three other mechanisms which we previously mentioned, other ways that the yeast to fungal conversion takes place is eliminating these bacteria. By doing that, we eliminate the antifungal substances that these bacteria produce in order to create space for themselves within this ecosystem of the digestive tract. So we eliminate something which would also suppress the yeast to fungal conversion. Also, when you take an antibiotic, you have immune system suppression. One of the uses for antibiotics commonly by the medical profession is to give someone an antibiotic as an anti-inflammatory. How you create this anti-inflammatory effect is that you eliminate substances called cytokines that are produced by white blood cells in the body. And how you eliminate these cytokines which promote inflammation is you eliminate the white blood cells that create this. So by taking an antibiotic, you also have immune system suppression, which eliminates inflammation. But the cytokines which contribute to inflammation do so on purpose. There's a purpose for these cytokines in the body, and it's through the body's own innate intelligence that these are produced in order to control infections, inflammations, and reduce disease and other conditions in the body.